So a very warm welcome to everyone here, and we've got the membering up as well. I can't see whether everyone who's on Zoom and Facebook, and those who will be joining us on YouTube. Everyone is very welcome as we celebrate the Ascension today. Listen. Alleluia. Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed.
The Lord be with
you. I will go to you.
Now, first hymn, Lord, I lift your name on high.
Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show me from the earth.
Lord, I love to sing your praises.
I love to sing your praises.
We pray our comment together. Almighty God, your Son Jesus Christ ascended to the throne of heaven that he might rule over all things as Lord. Keep the church in the unity of the Spirit and in the bond of peace, and bring the whole of creation to worship at his feet, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And Martin will lead us in our meeting.
Hear the word of the Lord according to the book of Acts. And this reading is taken from chapter 1, verses 1 to 11. In my former book, Theophilus, I wrote about all that Jesus began to do and to teach until the day he was taken up to heaven, after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles he had chosen. After his suffering, he presented himself to them and gave many convincing proofs that he was still alive. He appeared to them over a period of 40 days and spoke about the kingdom of God. On one occasion, while he was eating with them, he gave them this command: "Do not leave Jerusalem, but wait for the gift my Father promised, which you have heard me speak about. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit." And then they gathered around him and asked, "Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel?" He said to them, "It is not for you to know the times or dates the Father has set by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth." After he said this, he was taken up before their very eyes, and a cloud hid him from their sight. As they were looking intently up into the sky, suddenly two men dressed in white stood beside them. "Men of Galilee," they said, "why do you stand here looking into the sky? This same Jesus, who has been taken from you into heaven, will come back in the same way you have seen him go into heaven." This is the word of the Lord.
Let us pray. Lord, as we gather, we give thanks again for Jesus Christ, our Savior. born of Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, crucified, died and laid in a tomb, yet rose again. And today, as we remember the Ascension, we remember that he ascended into heaven for us, and that with his Ascension comes a promise of your Holy Spirit, hold it. So we pray, come, Holy Spirit. Come and guide us in our thoughts and our words as we reflect upon your word. As a boy growing up in Ayrshire, we as a family would often head out, often maybe down to one of the local beaches, maybe Troon or Brassey or somewhere else. Often a visit out into the Ayrshire countryside would often be accompanied by a drive past Preswick Airport. Glasgow's airport, was it Preswick, Glasgow? I don't know why they call it Preswick, Glasgow. There's a good 30 miles between the two. But Preswick Airport, a small airport, I don't know if any of you have lived from there. Famous people like Elvis landed, his only UK visit was at Preswick Airport. I'm sure that's going to edify and feed you today. But we used to go there and had an observation deck that you go out and watch some of the planes coming and going. I was always held in awe of the Sea King crew's base at HMS Gannet and the Sea and Air Rescue and their operations. See these helicopters take off and head out into who knows what situation to go out to rescue. And occasionally later, watching the news or reading in the newspaper, we would hear of the efforts of those brave men going out to rescue others. We would hear of the winchman being let down, maybe onto a hillside or round to the top, or maybe out into the rough seas and descending upon a boat or into the sea itself to rescue someone, coming down to bring salvation and rescue to those in need. Sometimes it might be three or four people coming down and going up, coming down and going up. The crewmen descended that those below might have life. They were to cling to this salvation that came down. They were to hold on tight, to be strapped to, and then be lifted up. Psalm 18, verse 16, says that the Lord reached down from on high. He took hold of me. He drew me up out of the deep waters. He rescued me. He brought me out into a safe place. He rescued me because he delighted in me. It's easy to make the link between that picture of a modern day yes, and rescue, and to consider the work of Jesus Christ. Jesus came down that we might be raised up. Jesus came down that we might know God's love. Jesus came down putting his own life at risk, giving up his own life to rescue us from sin and death eternal. Jesus came down, reached out, and and says, cling to me, hold on to me, abide in me, put your faith, put your trust in me. Lord, I can raise you. And then being raised up, he promises us a new life. We have to cast away the old things, to put on the new. And we have to live in the presence of God. For although Jesus physically ascended, the next part of the story that we explore next week is that the Holy Spirit is gifted, poured out onto all believers. We declare often in our services, the Lord is here. His Spirit is with us. The Lord is here. His Spirit is with us. In clinging to Christ and being raised up, we have to live with God in us and beside us. Yes, waiting for his return, but also living today as rescued, saved, lifted up people. People with a future and a hope in the ascended. Let us cling to the one who came down, that we might be raised up. Amen.
Response to Lord, in your mercy, is hear our prayer. Lord, in your mercy, we continue to thank the Lord for the success of the UK vaccination program against COVID-19. And we ask for a turning point and reduction in the horrendous death toll in countries like India and some South American countries. We, of course, only know about fatalities in countries which actually keep data, and there are many countries and refugee camps who do not. We pray for the UK, as the threat of the so-called Indian variant has now reached our shores and threatens to derail the vaccination progress made. We ask God to give all governments wisdom and courage to make unpopular decisions in the face of political and economic pressure. We also ask that you give us the patience and forbearance to continue with the restrictions and personal measures we have done for the last 15 months, so that we can rid our nation of this terrible disease and return to some degree of normality. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for peace in the world and an end to violence and war, praying especially at this time for the Israeli-Palestinian conflict, which has cost many lives and suffering, and which can potentially escalate into a much larger theater of war. May the leaders of both sides abandon their intransigent positions and start dialogue with a genuine desire to find compromise. Lord, as you look at the land in which you walked and lived 2,000 years ago, you must be so saddened to see it destroyed by guns, bombs, and hardline rhetoric. We pray for peace in your holy land. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all those who are ill, whether it be in body or mind. We ask God to give strength and courage to those with cancer and other chronic conditions. We know that many face mental health issues, and all these have been worsened by the COVID pandemic. We pray for our health service, whose staff are struggling to provide the care and support they've been trained to do, but now have limited resources and time. But there are bright spots of recovery and hope. We hear that Lily King has had her 1 year checkup and is cancer free. And for this, we thank you, Lord. May you continue to bless this courageous child and her family. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And finally, we pray for all those who are in need, those who are homeless or living in unhealthy conditions, those who are hungry and in need of food banks, those who are lonely and in need of friendship, those who are unemployed and in need of jobs, those without family and in need of love, those without any sense of purpose and in need of hope. Help us to do our part in sharing what we have with those who have not. Make us generous in spirit and in tangible contributions. We pray especially for the work of local organizations like Storehouse and international charities like Christian Aid. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We ask all these prayers in the name of Jesus, our ascended Lord and Savior. Amen.
May the peace of our risen and ascended Lord be always with you. Our creed is in the song that we are about to hear. Our Father, everlasting, the all-creating one.
Father everlasting, the all-creating one, God Almighty, through your Holy Spirit, conceiving Christ the Son, Jesus our Savior, I believe in God our Father. I believe in Christ the Son. I believe in the Holy Spirit. Our God is three in one. I believe in the resurrection, that we will rise again. For I believe in the name of Jesus. Defender suffered and crucified. Forgiveness is in you. Descended into darkness, you rose in glorious light. Forever seated high. I believe in God our Father. I believe in Christ the Son. I believe in the Holy Spirit.
I believe in life eternal. I believe in the virgin birth. I believe in the saints' communion and in your holy church. I believe in the resurrection when Jesus comes.
Risen and ascended, we gather at this day. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks.
Worship and praise belong to you, author of all being. Your power sustains, your love restores our broken world. And as children of your redeeming purpose, free by him who burst forth from the tomb and ascended to the throne of heaven, we offer you our praise with the angels and the archangels and the whole company of heaven. Sing the hymn of your unending glory. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Praise and thanksgiving be to you, our risen and ascended Lord. For by the cross, eternal life is ours, and death is swallowed up in victory. We remember before he was given up to suffering and death, at supper with his disciples, that Jesus gave thanks for the bread. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take, eat, this is my body. It is broken for you. After supper, he took the cup and offered thanks and praise. He gave it to his friends, saying, drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant. It is poured out for you and for all, that sins would be forgiven. Do this in remembrance of. We now obey your Son's command. We recall his blessed passion and death, his glorious resurrection and ascension, and we look for the coming of his kingdom. Made one with him, we offer you these gifts, and with them ourselves, a single, holy, living sacrifice. Hear us, most merciful Father. Send the promised gift of your Holy Spirit afresh upon each one of us, who is gathered here and who is gathered above. May that life givings give us new life as we take bread and bless it. We might be lifted, that we might ascend with you, to be children of the kingdom, gathered at your eternity. Help us who are baptized into the fellowship of Christ's Lord, to live and work to your praise and glory. May we grow together in unity and love until at last, in your new creation, we enter into our head in the company of the Virgin Mary, the apostles and prophets, and of all our brothers and sisters, living and departed, through Jesus Christ our Lord, with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be to you, Lord of all ages, world of men.
Amen.
The living bread is broken for the life of the world. Lord, unite us in this sign. So as Christ has taught us, we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trouble, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Let us mask, sanitize, receive, mask, sanitize, and return as we take the bread of communion. And bring in the sing to lift us up.
Camera.
Thanks to the Lord, for he is gracious, and his mercy
endures.
Our prayer of the communion. Father God, your Son, Jesus Christ, has sent us into all the world to preach the gospel of his kingdom. Help us by the power of the Holy Spirit to live and declare his good news. Hallelujah! Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Hallelujah. Christ our King, make you faithful and strong to do his will, that you may reign with him in glory, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you now and always. Amen. Closing hymn. There is vanity. Jesus, God's own Son.
There is a Redeemer, Jesus, God's own Son. Precious Lamb of God, Messiah, Holy One.
Thank you, oh my Father.
Thank you,
thank you, oh my Father.
And before I send you out, just a reminder, as is on the bottom of your pews or connectors, is now just to remember to book in for next week's Sunday service, which will be at St. Leonard's, all the time of 11:15. So if you want to be at that, just remember to contact the church office and book in. Go in peace to love and serve our ascended Lord. In the name of Christ, alleluia, alleluia, amen. And I think yes, say goodbye to everyone here and everyone on Facebook. Oh, sorry, I think there's Andrew wants to
regular SU magazine thingy, music thingy. This was one I just remarked, this is the first opportunity. So the one that you would be allowed to have is the one copy of the final website.
So for anyone who couldn't hear that, Andrew's put a pile of the SU magazines, yes, at the bottom of the church for you to take on your way out. So we'll say farewell to everyone and everyone on Zoom and Facebook.
I've also got notice of
I'll say goodbye eventually.
I was speaking to David and Shelley Stokes, our missionary partners from Argentina, although they are no longer in Argentina, but now back safely living in the UK. We would love to come and do a visit again, and although things have been freed up for that to begin to happen, they are going to join us on Zoom at the end of June for hopefully a Zoom chat about their work, just a debrief from the end of their time in Argentina to give that to us, and then hopefully as we progress into the later in the year they might come up for a little holiday and be with us, but in an official capacity, we wanted to kind of sign off by the end of June, and so if they could join us on the last Sunday in June for that worship time together. So it'd be lovely to see them then. Just to keep you informed of where they are. So bye to everyone on Facebook and Zoom, and do leave, but stay for a little while. Outside if you want to follow up.